Have you ever tried to find the perfect keywords in SEO for your videos, but then when you go look at the search results, you never show up within those search rankings? Well, that's because keywords won't rank your videos in search. Instead, you should try this strategy out. How's it going, content creators? My name is Ryan Walsh, and welcome back to the channel. We're all about mastering growth and monetization on YouTube so we can take control of our lives. So I know a lot of this is gonna be a little controversial, but I truly do not believe that keywords matter as much as they used to. When I first started growing on YouTube back in 2017, my first channel, I remember all of the hours I spent trying to find the perfect keywords, the perfect TubeBuddy scores for my SEO, and I just remember every single time I uploaded a video, I never ranked for the search terms I wanted. And if I did rank for a search term, it was always for this long tail keyword that nobody was looking for, and it basically resulted in me getting probably like 20 views, maybe 60 views, or if I was even lucky, I got 100 views on my video. Seriously, take a look at my old description. You can see how much time I put into this, but at the same time, I just keyword stuffed this description. After over 150 videos, maybe even to 200 videos, that's when I finally let that keyword and SEO strategy go, because obviously it just wasn't working for my channel. But once I started to really focus on my target audience and exactly what they wanted to see, that's when the views started flowing into my channel and I started gaining a ton of subscribers. Now, I'm not saying that you need to throw out keywords and you never need to use them in your videos, because that's not true at all. Instead, you really need to just look at keywords as basically just getting your foot in the door. So it's the first step into actually creating content that's gonna get you ranked in YouTube search. Let me give you an example from this channel. All right, so as you can see right here on the screen, you can see that this video right here is my most popular video with 284,000 views. And it's all about the 5 free ways to promote your new YouTube channel. And as we can see, if we just go right to the YouTube search bar and we type in how to promote your YouTube channel, you can see I'm ranking number 1. Now, this is not an incognito window, so the search results are catered to me. I do want to let you know that. But if we go to an incognito window, I'm ranked 2nd, but I've also been ranked 1st, and it really just goes back and forth. So I've been basically ranking in the top 2 videos for a really long time. We can go over to reach, and then all the way down to traffic source types. We want to click on see more. Once we click on see more, it's going to open this up and you're going to see that my click-through rate in the YouTube search bar, you can see I've had 217,000 views from here. It has a 9.3% click-through rate and a 3-minute and 30-second average view duration, which means that the bulk of my views came from YouTube search. The reason is because it has an extremely high click-through rate, a 9.3% within YouTube search. That's extremely high for a channel like mine. And then having a 3-minute, 30-second average view duration on that is just really great as well. And now I know what a lot of you guys are thinking. You're thinking to yourself,
well, it's because you had so many subscribers at the time.
That's not true. Actually, if we go back to July 30th, 2020, in my live subscriber count, I had 176 subscribers at the time. I was competing with channels that had over 1 million subscribers. Some on here even have almost 100,000 subscribers. This one has 400,000 subscribers. So it shows you that if you do want to rank in YouTube search, the only thing you really have to do is get a really high click-through rate and a pretty good audience retention for that specific YouTube search term. I also wanted to mention this video right here, just because we're talking about keywords and SEO, and that was all about YouTube tags. And I saw a lot of your comments on that video, and I noticed that a lot of people definitely were misunderstanding exactly the purpose of the video, and that's why I kind of wanted to clear it up. The first point that I always saw in the comments was that the test wasn't fair because I had such a big audience and tags are only there for smaller YouTubers, which definitely is not true. If that was true and it was just because of the size of my audience, then none of my videos would ever underperform. On average, usually I get anywhere between 3,000 to 6,000 views on all my videos. Sometimes, usually, it goes even over that. So with this video only getting 1,200 views, that just means it really just underperformed. And YouTube actually tells you this, and it tells you why in your analytics. It basically just says this video underperformed because fewer people were clicking on the video or fewer people were watching all the way through. And that's why the video underperformed. It never says the reason why this didn't perform is because you didn't have YouTube tags on the video. That is never the reason. My second point is that YouTube themselves basically tells creators that tags are only used for misspellings within your description in your title. So in reality, they don't help you rank or get you discovered on the platform. And I know this is like big conspiracy that YouTube is just trying to keep their creators small so that the bigger creators can just keep succeeding. But if you think about it, YouTube is a business, right? Obviously, they want to make money and they want to make money off of your videos. So that's why they try to inform you on exactly how the YouTube algorithm works so that you can make better videos that are going to make you and them a lot more money. And then the third point is that I never said throughout the entire video, don't put tags on your videos. This was just a test that I did on one of my own videos. And you basically could just go on there and make your own assumption of exactly what that meant. And actually, at the end of the video, I did say, make sure that you're always putting in your YouTube tags because you just want to make sure you're doing your best practices all the time throughout your videos. And at the end of the day, it doesn't hurt your video, so why not just put YouTube tags in your video? And that's basically what I was saying. The whole purpose of that video was just to show you guys, don't put hours upon hours upon hours within the description, keywords, SEO, and tags. It doesn't make a difference on your video. The thing that's really gonna make a difference is actually making better content, and that's what you should be focusing on. That was the whole point of that video, and I think it was just a little misunderstood. All right, so it's great that we know all of this information, but exactly how are we gonna put this into action? Well, the first thing you really wanna do, action number one, is that you wanna identify exactly what keyword you're going after. The best ways to do this is looking just in the YouTube search bar and letting it autofill, but my personal favorite thing to do is basically just look within TubeBuddy. And if you haven't downloaded TubeBuddy already, I actually have a free 30-day trial for you guys. So you can go on there and not just get the free version of TubeBuddy, but you can actually get one of the license levels and you can get it completely for free for 30 days. So it's honestly a great deal. Make sure you guys check that out if you haven't already. So of course you can see right here, I'm gonna go over to TubeBuddy. I can just look up something like how to invest in real estate, basically looking up this keyword and say I want to make a video on this topic. Well, you can see that the search volume, this is specifically what I want to look at, you can see that there's actually a lot of traffic around this one search topic. So in my opinion, that's actually a great keyword to go after. However, sometimes I really like to take out how to and just look at invest in real estate, because a lot of the time people aren't even looking for that. And you can see the search volume is even greater for this. And what's even better about TubeBuddy is that they actually have a Google Trends little graph over here. You can see the interest over time within the last 30 days, or you can even go all the way back to the last 12 months. Say we're gonna make a video on this topic. Perfect, we've identified exactly what keywords we're going after, which is invest in real estate. And I know this can get very complicated. You can look at the competition and be a little nervous about that, or you can be nervous about the optimization strength, but I really just want you to focus on the search volume for right now. All right, action number two is that we want to go right into the results, and we can do that right here on TubeBuddy. We can see all of the results for invest in real estate. And what we're really looking for here is, first, we're gonna look at all the different thumbnails. Of course, they're a little small, so sometimes what I like to do is just go into an incognito window, and then we wanna look right at the thumbnails on just a bigger page, and you can see them all right here. And we wanna ignore the ad. You never wanna look at the ad first. So we can see all the different thumbnails, and we basically wanna find all the patterns. So is there a close-up of face? Are there a lot of text on the thumbnail? Is there something really catchy on the thumbnail? Is there a before and after? What are on these thumbnails that obviously these viewers are really intrigued by and why they wanted to click on these thumbnails? And you're gonna do the exact same thing with the titles. Is it teasing a specific moment in the video? Is it promising result? All this stuff really matters. And if you can identify all the different patterns, you can go and rank in one of these search terms that's really competitive. I can see that obviously there are a lot of close-up faces on these thumbnails within the first four here, but you can definitely see that there's also some text on the majority of these thumbnails. So close-up of face, a lot of text. And I also think this thumbnail from Bigger Pockets is really impressive as well, because it basically says how to make $1 million. That's something obviously if you're trying to invest in real estate, you want to make $1 million. So that's something that's just teasing that audience within the thumbnail. So obviously that's a great strategy to get ranked at the top of the search results. Not only that, but also looking at the titles, you can see 5 successful real estate investing tips for 2020. So obviously he's being a little bit more relevant for the Rich Dad channel. So you can see these titles are really catchy and isn't just something that's really boring. Action number three is to just make a good video. Sounds easy, right? Well, it's not entirely that easy, but at the same time, let me explain to you exactly what I mean by that. Well, if I'm trying to target YouTube search, what I'll usually do is I'll go into the search term that I'm really looking for on YouTube, then I'll see all the top videos that are at the top of those search results, and I'll basically watch the first four or five videos and write down exactly what are they doing in the video, what makes this video stand out, and also how can I add my own unique maybe tips, maybe just my own unique perspective, whatever it is, how can your video be different from all those other videos? Not only this, but I'll also look at all the comments in those videos as well, and basically just kind of get a summary of exactly what did a lot of people like about these videos, and whatever they liked, I usually try to insert that into my video as well, because that's literally your target audience saying exactly what they liked about that video, and you want to make sure that you're always trying to please your target audience. Not only that though, but also editing is a huge part of how to make a great video for your audience. I've actually learned a couple different editing strategies that actually keep my audience watching longer than usual, and most of the time it's really just adding a bunch of B-roll in my videos, or it's just by adding text in my videos as well. And you can see obviously throughout this entire video, I've been adding text, and the reason is because I've seen that people watch longer when I add text in my videos. And these subtle little changes can really make your video stand out and make it so your audience retention is longer, so YouTube promotes that video more in the search results. Action step number four is to fill out your description and make sure you're adding in those keywords that you want to add in. Now, and the way I'm going to be doing this is I actually am uploading a video right now to my YouTube channel, how to get comfortable on camera. And so basically the keywords that I'm going after here are obviously comfortable on camera. And so I would say in this video, I'm going to share how to get more comfortable on camera. This way you can come off more confident on camera and get more views. So you can see the first line is basically just what's the video about? And that's literally, you just want to keep it super simple. The second one is why do they want to watch this video? So you can see this way you can come off more confident on camera and get more views, because why do they want to be confident on camera? Well, they want to get more views on their videos and just get better at filming. But that is exactly how I structure my description so I can get a lot more views on my videos. Now, keywords aren't the only thing that's misunderstood on YouTube, because tags aren't as useful as they used to be. And that's exactly what I prove in this video right here. So be sure to click on that, and I'll see you guys over there. Bye-bye.